Hey there, welcome back to my channel. So today I have a pretty short September favorites actually. It's been a really, really busy month for me. So I chose six fragrances to talk through that I've been kind of the most I've worn this month for sure. And then I have two makeup favorites that I'll save for the end as well. If you haven't subscribed already, don't forget to subscribe, ring the bell so you'll be notified every time I put out new videos. And also, I will leave my Instagram as I always do, so you can follow me there as well. So let's get into it. September, weather-wise, has been, you know, very warm, sunny, summery days, and also very cold fall days. So I actually noticed as I was pulling out my six that I have kind of my two warm day fragrances, my two middle of the road, where it's kind of like hot in the afternoon but cold in the morning, and two of my colder day fragrances, so it works out perfectly. And then, as I say, I'll leave the two makeup favorites for the end. So my two warm day, summery, it's still deep in summer, fragrances. The first one is Virgin Island Water by Creed. I kind of just tried to get the last few days I could out of this. I will still probably wear this in fall and winter on the days that I'm missing summery weather, because I do tend to do that, but this is a stunner. It's kind of beautiful, coconut, lime, copra, stunning, stunning fragrance, and I cannot get enough. It is so delicious, and it's been really nice to have a few last days to wear this. And a surprising one for me, and I don't know why, but I've just been super drawn to Delina by Parfum de Marly this September on, again, the more warm days, but I think it's because it's starting to have randomly good, well, better lasting power on me, whereas before it was kind of like an hour or less. Some days in the summer it was like an hour, which was ridiculous. Now it's getting a little bit better, and it's so up to chance that you never do know, so you do have to kind of keep it around, with which for the price is disappointing, but I don't know why, I've just been really, really craving Delina. So that was the second one that I definitely wore on the warmer, sunny days. Then your middle of the day fragrances. The first one I'm gonna spend literally no time on because I talk about it so much, but I have to be realistic, and that is Zadigan Voltaire. This is her. I've already reached up to here on this fragrance, which I have not had it that long. I'm just blowing through this, you guys. It is beautiful, lactonic, dream, chestnut cream, vanilla. I really, really do love this. And I get so many compliments on this as well. So love that. The other one is a men's fragrance. It's actually Terre d'Hermès, the Eau de Toilette. This I've mentioned before, it really does, like I'll spray it here and the opening has a bitter citrus, almost like if you're smelling the rinds of it, note. And that, you know, it's nice, but it's definitely bitter. Do not let that fool you, because literally 5 minutes in, sometimes less, the heart and dry down of this fragrance are to die for. And the sillage that you will get just moving around after, once you get to that heart down, there is something intoxicating about it that I cannot explain. And I love spraying it on my arms, actually my forearms, when I'm working at my desk, because after a couple minutes, it'll just stay with me kind of almost the whole working day, honestly, or I'll, you know, keep it next to my desk and I'll spray it if I see that it's going away. And the sillage on this is stunning. It's absolutely stunning, and I love it. I also love this packaging where you just roll it down. I think it's really great. And yeah, definitely, definitely recommend. And then, as I say, unfortunately for me, because I really, fall is my least favorite season, which I know somehow is controversial because everyone loves fall, but I really do not like fall. I've tried to make myself feel better on the colder fall days with warm, delicious fragrances that I adore. The first one is new to my collection, newer, and it's Iris Prima by Penhaligon's. I got it when it was still warm out, and I think it, because of like that suede leatheriness, it does do better now. It's kind of like your cold weather iris, honestly, and I've really gotten into suede recently as a note, and this is just, it's a leathery suede goodness, and it's irisy, it's like slightly powdered, but it's definitely a cool time iris, and yeah, I really, really do love it. Absolutely love it, and it's helped to brighten up the rainy fall days. And the other one, which had to be said, was Alien Essence Absolue. I'm just checking. I always think it's 80 mil, but it's 60 mil. Oh my god, you guys. I mean, it goes without saying, this is the most beautiful Alien. I mean, it's just gourmand, and it's warm, and it's jasmine. It's got that alienness, but even better. Even better. I just love this. This has really helped to brighten up the colder days, and you really don't need a lot of this because I find it's quite strong and definitely sticks around, especially if you get it in your hair or on your clothing. Oh, I just love it. So definitely had to include that. Have been loving it in September, and I'll probably continue to wear it all of fall, honestly. And then my two makeup favorites, very quickly, I've got them both on today. For my lips, I've loved for many years, but definitely been loving the Buxom, the pumping lip glosses that I adore in the shade Gabby. It's kind of like a slight pinky purple mauve shade. I love these pumping lip glosses. I love the like minty coolness to it. And the Gabby shade is really, really stunning. And then the other favorite is a blush. I don't know if NYX sells this anymore, but the Ombre blushes, and this is in OB07. I think that's what it's called. It's just like a coral. The ombre honestly is barely an ombre because it's just this little top part, which you can barely get to, but this coral, I am a sucker for a coral blush, and it's a stunner. So yeah, have been really loving those two. I hope you guys enjoyed. As always, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye.